You will now see the ML estimate in action. First, we'll see the theorem and its proof, which is quite easy now because we have our lemma that we can take the norm inside our integral. And then we will move on to our first example, an integral where finding the antiderivative is really hard, but which can be easily estimated with our theorem. So let us have a look. So what's the theorem? It says the following. If your the norm of your f of z is smaller or equal than some number m for all z on the curve C, then we can estimate our integral. The norm of our integral is smaller or equal than m, this maximum of f in norm, times L, where L is the length of the curve. So all we need to do is that we need to be able to estimate how big our function is going to be. And then the integral is at most its maximum times the length of the curve we are integrating along. So why is this true? Well, any integral along a curve C f dz, how do we compute it? Well, you parameterize C by writing z equals r of t, where r parameterizes your curve t. And then you integrate from a to b. You plug in your parameterization in f, and you take do this times r prime, so z prime times dt. And we are over there. And we compute, want to know something about the norm of this quantity. Well, then our lemma is very useful because the norm of an integral is smaller or equal than the integral of the norm. So you can take the norm inside the integral. And then we are over there. Ah, and then we're almost there because the norm of f times z prime equals the norm of f times the norms of z prime, which is over here. And then the function f times z prime is smaller than the function of m times z prime because f is smaller than m. And now we have to do only with real functions. So we have a function norm of f times norm of z prime, which is smaller than the function norm of m times the norm of z prime. So then its integral is also smaller. And then we're over here. And then you're happy because you can take out the m. You can take it in front. It doesn't depend on t. So you have the integral of m times the integral of z prime dt. And you know that the integral of the norm of z prime dt is the same as the integral of r prime dt is the length of the curve C. And then we are over there. So we see that the norm of our integral is smaller or equal than m times L. Well, how can we use that? Let's do an example. We have our function z of 1 plus z to the power 4 dz. We want to integrate it along the circle on the upper half plane with radius r. So the length of our circle, well, that's easy. It's half of a circle of radius r. So the length of the curve C is just pi times r. That's the easy part. But then we also need to estimate f. We want to find an m, which will depend on r. So we usually call this mr in the end, such that f is smaller or equal than this mr. So how are we going to find that? Well, the norm of f equals the norm of z over 1 plus z to the power 4 equals the norm of the numerator divided by the norm of the denominator. So the norm of the numerator is fine, the norm of z. And we know that because z lives on this arc. So the norm of z is just r. So that's fine. For the denominator, we need to be a bit more careful. We have to estimate the norm of 1 plus z to the power 4. And we have to show that it is bigger than something, because then the 1 over z to the power 4 becomes smaller than something. So careful here. Well, we know we can use the triangle inequality. The norm of a plus b is bigger or equal than the absolute value of the norm of a minus the norm of b. That's what we do over here. Well, then we know the norm of z to the power 4 equals norm of z to the power 4. We can take the power 4 out, which happens over there. And then we are happy again because z lives on the circle, so the norm of z is again r. So we get the absolute value of 1 minus r to the power 4. And we take our r big, so certainly bigger than 1, which was an assumption already over there. So the modulus of 1 minus r to the power 4 equals r to the power 4 minus 1. And that's what we plug in into our MR estimate. And we know that the norm of f of z is smaller or equal than r, the easy one, divided by r to the power 4 minus 1. And that's what we will call our MR. And then, well, we we can apply the theorem. In conclusion, the norm of the integral smaller or equal than mr times the length of the curve, we chose as our mr, r divided r to the power 4 minus 1. Length of the curve is just pi r. So in conclusion, our integral is bounded by pi r squared over r to the power 4 minus 1. Well, we will typically use this for very large r, so we will send r to infinity. So what happens, r goes to infinity? Well, you can evaluate this limit, for example, by dividing by r to the power 4. And then you will see easily that this limit will be 0. So this means that for r to infinity, the norm of our integral will go to 0. So the integral itself will go to 0 as r goes to infinity. So even though we couldn't compute the antiderivative explicitly, we can still see what happens with our integral for r going to infinity. And that is how we are going to use this theorem a lot later on.